The idea behind this album, Spheres, is in a way based on this rather unusual, even quirky discovery, let's call it a discovery, by Pythagoras thousands of years ago, that the planets, when they move, they create sound. He was fascinated by this, as were so many artists, mathematicians, musicians over the next 2,000 years. And many of them tried to conjure up the sound of something out there. And the idea with Spheres was to try and bring these sounds together from a variety of composers over 400 or 500 years.
It's this amazing building we're recording in that was the home of the East German Broadcast Corporation, which is amazing, and it's very oldie-worldy and hasn't really changed a lot, I think, in 60 years.
There is every kind of emotion on this album, from the most serene and beautiful to extremely upbeat tempos, jazzy, funky things. It's really the idea of where can music transport you to what kind of a plane. And that for me is very exciting. Have a number of world premieres. Young composers like Gabriel Prokofiev or Carsten Gundermann, who have specifically written for this project, they knew that this album was called Spheres, so there was something spherical about it, something about getting back in touch with where this music has come from, and at the same time, lifting to a kind of a spiritual level. We have some Bach, we have some Westhoff, but it's been arranged by composers who are living today. Tell us a little bit about Biafra. What does that mean? Where does this piece come from?
So Biafra was from a project I've recently worked on for a film about a photographer called Don McCullen, who took some amazing photos of all these wars throughout, from Vietnam to Biafra and all through the 60s and 70s and 80s for the Sunday Times magazine. This specific part of the film looked at an orphanage that McCullen found and came across with 800 kids that, when he turned up, thought he was there to save them. Of course, he wasn't. He was there to take photographs. So that piece really came out of, inspired by his photographs, really, which is a new experience for me, kind of writing music to these black and white photographs from 40 years ago.
It's now an interesting time because we look back at this huge burden of music that we have over the years and we ask ourselves, what's going to happen? Where are we going? And there are many composers that are courageous enough to write melodies nowadays. And the question is there a place for them? I think yes, of course there has to be, because melody is what speaks to us as human beings.